everyone. I welcome you all to RKP online classes. Today we will start our new topic, that is solution. The topic is from same chapter, that is states of matter. So in previous video we have covered that what if we will heat any one state of matter or if we will cool down. So we have done that heating and cooling can change the state of matter. If we want to change solid into liquid, we have to heat. If we want to change liquid into gas, we have to heat. Then if we will come reverse, if we want to change gas into liquid, we have to cool down. If we want to change liquid into solid, we have to cool down. So simply heating and cooling can change the state of matter, but one thing we have done very important, that every matter will not change its state at same temperature. If you are taking different type of matter, for example, if I talk about water only, one you are taking pure water, second you are taking water from any lake or river, third you are taking water from the oceans or sea, or fourth you are taking water from RO. These are four types of water. So that state of matter is same, matter is also same, but if you will try to change this water into gaseous form, or if you will try to change this water into its solid form, that is ice, they all will change at different temperature because they all are not same. Clear? So why they are not same? Because if we talk about ocean water is not pure water, that is saline water. What type of water is ocean water? That is saline water. Saline water means mixture of salt and water. Means salt is present in water. So if the matter is not pure, or if you are taking one pure matter and the same matter you are taking along with some impurities, then there will be difference in the temperature at which they will change their state. So in previous video I have told you the boiling point of pure water, the melting point of pure water, pure ice, and freezing point of pure water. Three things: boiling point of pure water, you have to write down this. Boiling point means at which temperature pure water will boil. Then melting point of pure ice means at which temperature ice made up of pure water will start melting. And freezing point means at which temperature the pure water will freeze and change into ice. Write down this in your notebook. The temperatures: first, write down fast. I hope you all have written in your notebook the boiling point, freezing point, and melting point. So I am telling you this, just check your answer. The boiling point of pure water is 100 degrees Celsius. The freezing point of pure water is 0 degrees Celsius. And melting point of pure ice is 0 degrees Celsius. Check your answers. If it is incorrect, cut it and make it correct. Okay. So, let's come upon our new topic, that is solution. What is solution? Before than that, I'll tell you one thing. We are having three states of matter: solid, liquid, and gas. What if we are taking different types of matter and mixing with each other? For example, I have taken two pencils, or I have taken one pen and one pencil, and I have put in a box. Or I have taken 10 pens and 10 pencils and I have put in a box. Pen and pencil both are which form of matter? Both are solids. It means I have mixed different types of solids, right? So they will mix together properly, is it easy, is it will be easy to separate them or it will be very difficult to separate them? So you can easily tell that it will be very easy to separate them because we have mixed them, but they have not mixed properly with each other, they have not dissolved with each other, they are just put together. So such type of activity if we will do, then we will not get a solution, we will get mixture. What we will get? Mixture. For example, you are having pulses at home. Before cooking pulses or before cooking rice, what your mother does, your mother clean it, means your mother separate stones from that pulses or from that rice, and then she will cook, right? Then she will wash also, and then she will cook. So what is she doing? She is separating two solids. Pulses are also solid and stones are also solid. How it can be separated? Because they are just put together, they are not properly dissolved into each other, so as we cannot separate them. We can separate them easily, so that are known as mixtures. So it means if we mix one solid with another solid, if we mix one solid with another solid, we will not get a solution. What we will get? Mixtures. Clear? Then what if we are taking one matter in solid form and we are taking one matter in liquid form? What I am saying, I am taking one matter in solid form and one matter in liquid form. Then I am mixing it. If I am mixing it, there will be two chances. One will be, both will mix properly with each other, that after mixing you cannot separate them easily, or after mixing you cannot see them separately. Aap dono ko alag alag dekh bhi nahi paoge, you will get only one substance. Means both things will mix up with each other properly, means the solid will properly dissolve in liquid. What word I am using? Dissolve. And the other option or other chance will be that we are mixing that solid into liquid, we are stirring it, still we can see them separately and we can separate them very easily. Hum unko dekh bhi sakte hain properly alag alag, aur hum unko separate bhi kar sakte hain. So how we can say that? We will do by taking one example. Example, I am taking one glass filled with water, not fully filled with water, 75% I have filled the glass with water. I have put 2 spoons of sugar in it. I have stirred it. After stirring for few minutes, I saw that the water was at the same level, but I am not able to see where are the sugar particles. Here I have taken a glass of water, I have put 2 spoons of sugar, I have stirred it. Hilane ko kya kehte hai ise? Stir karna, S-T-I-R. I have stirred it for few minutes regularly, and after that I have observed that I am not able to see sugar particles. And one thing more I have observed, that water is still at same level. Agar main water mein kuch dal rahi hu, then water should rise, the level of water should rise, but water is at same level. So two questions arises here. One is that where are the sugar particles? The second question is why the water is still at same level? What are the two questions which arises here? Where are the sugar particles and why the water is at same level? If I have put more thing in the glass, the water level should rise. So think over it and try to answer. Till we will do another example. This I have taken of this, and another example, if I have taken one glass of water, I have put some, you can say pencil shaving, jab aap pencil sharp karte ho,
उसका जो गार्बेज होता है, रबिश होता है, उसको पेंसिल शेविंग कहते हैं. और आई हैव टेकन सम अमाउंट ऑफ सैंड और मड, आई हैव पुट इन द ग्लास, सेम टू स्पून्स आई हैव टेकन एंड आई हैव स्टर इट फॉर फ्यू मिनट्स, सेम एज आई हैव डन इन फर्स्ट केस. After that, I have left the glass and I have observed that here are the sand particles or pencil shavings. Either you will find here or you will find here. The thing you are mixing, either you will find separately with water, it means you can see easily. If I am taking sand, I will observe that sand particles are here at the bottom and water has risen the level. The level of water has risen. पहले इतना था और अब ऊपर हो गया, means risen. Clear? So what I have taken, if you have paid attention, you should observe that I have taken one solid matter. What I have taken? Sugar. Sugar is solid. And in what I have mixed? I have mixed in liquid. So I have taken one matter in solid form. And I have taken another matter in liquid form. So, what I have done? I have mixed solid and liquid together. So, two cases are in front of me. In first case, the sugar particles disappeared. Means, we are not able to observe sugar particles after few minutes. It means, sugar particles properly dissolved in water. And in second case, I have mixed sand in water, but I am able to observe sand particles in water after few minutes, or even you can see after 1 hour also. It means sand do not dissolve in water. Sand do not dissolve in water. Sugar dissolve in water. Sand particles do not dissolve in water. It means, beta, every solid cannot be mixed in every liquid. It means every solid cannot dissolve in every liquid. Clear? So, if that solid dissolve in liquid, we will say that soluble substance. What do we say? If the solid is dissolving in the liquid, here we are taking water as liquid. Why we are taking water as liquid? We will take water in each and every case. Why we are taking water as liquid? Because water is universal solvent. What is water? Universal solvent. So, what do you mean by solvent? I'll tell you. Universal means accepted all over the world. So, we have taken two types of solid. First, we have taken sugar and we have dissolved in water. Second, we have taken salt. And we have mixed in water. First sugar mix in water, second salt mix in water. In that case, sugar properly dissolved in water, and in this case, sand here it will come. Sand is not dissolving in water, so does not dissolve. So the solid which dissolved in water, which can be dissolved in water. वो सॉलिड जो वॉटर में अच्छे से डिजोल्व हो सकता है, दे आर नोन एज सोल्यूबल सब्सटेंसेस. व्हाट दे आर नोन एज सोल्यूबल सब्सटेंसेस. एंड द सॉलिड विच कैन नॉट बी डिजोल्व इन वॉटर, दे आर नोन एज इनसोल्यूबल सब्सटेंसेस. दे आर नोन एज इनसोल्यूबल सब्सटेंसेस. सो if we are talking about soluble substances and if we are mixing in liquid, any liquid, you can take here milk also, you can take here juice also, oil also. So if you are taking any solid and if it is properly dissolving in that liquid, then you get a new substance that is known as solution. What will you get? Solution. जब आप एक सॉलिड को लिक्विड में प्रॉपरली डिजोल्व कर दोगे तो जो आपको रिजल्ट मिलेगा उसको हम कहेंगे सॉल्यूशन. सो इफ यू आर ऑब्टेनिंग अ सॉल्यूशन, द सॉलिड इज नोन एज सॉल्यूट एंड द लिक्विड इज नोन एज सॉल्वेंट. जो सॉलिड आप लोगे दैट इज कॉल्ड सॉल्यूट एंड द लिक्विड विच विल यू विल टेक इट इज नोन एज सॉल्वेंट एंड व्हेन यू विल मिक्स बोथ यू विल गेट अ सॉल्यूशन. सो व्हाट आई मीन टू से सॉल्यूट व्हेन डिसॉल्वड इन सॉल्वेंट इज कॉल्ड सॉल्यूशन. जिसको मिक्स किया जाता है उसको सॉल्यूट कहते हैं, जिसमें मिक्स किया जाता है उसको सॉल्वेंट कहते हैं, और जो हमें ऑब्टेन होता है उसको कहते हैं सॉल्यूशन. सो हेयर वी आर टेकिंग शुगर बिकॉज शुगर इज लेस इन अमाउंट एंड वी आर पुटिंग इन वॉटर सो वॉटर इज मोर इन अमाउंट. शुगर बींग शुगर विल बी सेड एज सॉल्यूट. किसमें मिक्स कर रहे हैं हम? वॉटर में. तो वॉटर को हम क्या बोलेंगे? सॉल्वेंट. और वट डू वी गेट? सॉल्यूशन. So here I have told you many things together. First I have told you that we are mixing solid into liquid. Two cases will be there. Firstly, whether they will be mixed together or they will not be mixed together properly. If they are mixing together properly, then that substance जो आप mix कर रहे हो, then that substance is known as soluble substance. If they are not mixing together properly, then that substance is known as insoluble substance. And अगर वो properly dissolve हो रहे हैं, then जिस चीज जिस सब्सटेंस को आप डिसॉल्व कर रहे हो दैट इज कॉल्ड सॉल्यूट. जिसमें डिसॉल्व कर रहे हो दैट इज कॉल्ड सॉल्वेंट एंड व्हाट यू विल गेट? सॉल्यूशन. क्लियर? सो आई विल शो यू सॉल्यूबल सब्सटेंसेस एंड इनसॉल्यूबल सब्सटेंसेस थ्रू एन एक्टिविटी. फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन टू क्वेश्चन आई हैव टोल्ड यू प्रीवियसली दैट व्हाट टू केसेस अराइज. फर्स्ट वेयर आर द शुगर पार्टिकल्स. व्हाट वॉज द सेकेंड क्वेश्चन? दैट व्हाई द वॉटर लेवल वॉज सेम. Why the water level was same beta? The sugar particles when dissolving in water. Water is what? Liquid. What is the arrangement of molecules in liquid? In liquid the molecules are having space in between. So when we dissolve sugar in water, the sugar particles after dissolving take the space which is present in between the molecules of water. So sugar ke particles water ke molecules ke beech mein jo स्पेस थी उसी में एडजस्ट हो गए, इसलिए वाटर जितना था उतना ही रहा. लेकिन यू विल ऑब्जर्व वन थिंग मोर कि जब शुगर डिसॉल्व करने के बाद वाटर थोड़ा आपको थिक लगेगा. पहले इतना वाटर थिक नहीं था जब नॉर्मल जब आपने वाटर लिया था, लेकिन शुगर डिसॉल्व करने के बाद आपको थिक लगेगा. क्यों? बिकॉज अर्लियर देयर वाज मच स्पेस इन बिटवीन द मॉलिक्यूल्स. नाउ शुगर पार्टिकल्स हैव टेकन द स्पेस, दैट्स व्हाई द मॉलिक्यूल्स मींस द मेटल सीम्स टू बी थिक. क्लियर? बट स्पेस वॉज देयर, दैट्स वाई एक्स्ट्रा स्पेस शुगर ने नहीं ली. शुगर ने एक्स्ट्रा स्पेस नहीं ली क्योंकि उनको वॉटर के अंदर ही स्पेस मिल गई, मॉलिक्यूल्स के अंदर ही स्पेस मिल गई, दैट्स वाई वॉटर का लेवल सेम था. लेकिन सैंड के केस में क्या हुआ? सैंड पार्टिकल्स कैन नॉट बी डिजॉल्व इन वॉटर, ये उसकी प्रॉपर्टी है. तो सैंड ने अपनी अलग स्पेस ली, वॉटर ऊपर हो गया, दैट्स वाई द लेवल ऑफ वॉटर हैज राइजन. सो this was the case of solid when mixed in liquid. Clear? So I am showing you soluble substances and insoluble substances through an activity. Clear?
Now I will show you soluble substances and insoluble substances. I will show you by mixing that some type of substances dissolve in water and some types of substances do not dissolve in water. So the substances which dissolve in water are called soluble substances and the substances which do not dissolve in water are called insoluble substances. So to make a solution we need soluble substances, and I will show you how solid when mixes in liquid make a solution. So here I have taken two glasses and I have put water in them. In this glass the level of the water is this, I have marked, and in this glass the level of the water is this. In one glass I will put some amount of sugar and in one glass I will put some amount of sand in it. So I am putting in first glass 1 spoon of sugar and in another glass I will put 1 spoon of sand. Clear? You can see easily in this glass sugar is there and in the another glass sand is there. So in first glass I am stirring the solution, means I am stirring the liquid, and after few minutes you will see that sugar particles disappeared. You will see that sugar particles
disappeared. You can clearly see that sugar particles started becoming smaller in size, means they are shrinking in size because most of them have been dissolved in water. So continuously stirring it for few minutes will, after that it will totally disappear. Sugar particles will totally disappear. Now you can clearly see that sugar particles totally disappeared. And if you will observe here, the level of the water is still the same. The level of the water is still the same. This is because the sugar particles has taken the space in between the molecules of the water. As we know that water is liquid, and in liquid the molecules have space in between them. So the sugar particles, after being dissolved in water, have taken the space in between the molecules of water, and they have not taken any extra space. That is why the level of the water is still the same. Now see, in another glass I have put the sand and I have dissolved it for few minutes. Continuously I am stirring this solution, and after stirring also you can clearly see the sand particles in this, because the sand does not dissolve in water, and that is why we say that sand is insoluble in water. What do we say? Sand is insoluble in water because sand does not dissolve in water. And if you will look carefully, the level of the water has risen because the sand particles have not dissolved in water. They have taken extra space. That is why the level of the water has risen.
I hope you have understood the soluble substances and insoluble substances through the activity. So next our topic is when liquid mixed in another liquid. When liquids get mixed in another liquid, we will get two cases. One case we will get when both the liquids mix properly and we are not able to see them separately, and second case we will get when both liquids do not mix with each other and we are not able to see them. We are able to see them properly. Jab ek dusre ke andar acche se mix ho jayenge, hum unhe alag alag nahi dekh sakte. When they do not mix with each other properly, then we can see them separately. So how we can say here, you can take one example. When you will put some few drops of ink in water, then you will get one solution in which you cannot see ink separately, in which you cannot see water separately. जो आपको नया solution मिलेगा उसमें ना आप ink को अलग देख सकते हो ना water को अलग देख सकते हो, right? सेकेंड केस जो है जिसमें नहीं मिक्स होते, वेरी कॉमन एग्जाम्पल इट इज वेन यू विल पुट फ्यू ड्रॉप्स ऑफ ऑयल इन वॉटर, देन यू विल सी दैट अ लेयर ऑफ ऑयल फॉर्म्स ओवर द वॉटर बिकॉज ऑयल डज नॉट मिक्स इन वॉटर. क्लियर? हेयर इंक इज ऑल्सो लिक्विड, वॉटर इज ऑल्सो लिक्विड, ऑयल इज ऑल्सो लिक्विड, वॉटर इज ऑल्सो लिक्विड. सो वट वी आर मेकिंग सोल्यूशन ऑफ लिक्विड इन टू विथ अनदर लिक्विड. So the liquids which mix together properly, they are known as miscible liquids. Pay attention, this topic is not given in your book, so you will not find anywhere. When two liquids mix with each other properly and we are not able to see them separately after mixing, then they are known as miscible liquids. What they are known as? Miscible liquids. Pay attention to the spelling. And if one liquid does not mix with another liquid and we can see them separately, they are known as immiscible liquids. What they are known as? Immiscible liquids. Pay attention, most of the students do spelling mistake here. Opposite of miscible is immiscible, not inmiscible. IN nahi hai ye, immiscible. So how many, if we are making solution of liquid with another liquid, we will get two cases. One case will be of miscible liquids, another case will be of immiscible liquids. Clear?
So now I will show you the solution of liquid with another liquid, means I am mixing two types of liquid with each other. So I have told you that if the liquids mix with each other, they are known as miscible liquids, and if liquids do not mix with each other, they are known as immiscible liquids. So in this class I have taken some water and I will mix ink into it. As we all know that ink is insoluble, ink is in liquid state, and I will put few drops of ink into it. You can see properly that ink started dissolving in water itself. So ink is soluble in water, so ink and water are miscible liquids.
I hope you have understood the topic of liquid with liquid solution. Now next topic is gas into liquid, the solution of gas and liquid. You will say that, ma'am, how we can add gas into liquid? The very first example and the very big example is there in front of us also, that is water. Yes, there are gases dissolved in water. If you remember, in the video number 4, when water was boiling, when I was doing the activity and when I was showing you the process of evaporation, when water was boiling, I have shown you that bubbles were appearing in the container. Yes or no? Bubbles were appearing, na? And I have told you that why the bubbles are appearing, I will tell you in next video if you have observed that video carefully. Clear? So that answer I will give you here, that water contain gases. So water, if we heat the water, jab hum heat karenge to kiske molecules jaldi spread hoenge here and there, liquid or gas ke? Gases obviously, because the molecules are firstly they are very far apart and they do not have any force of attraction, to wo jaldi escape hone ki try karenge. Escape means come out. So when we heat the water, the gases which are present in water try to come out, aur jab water mein se gases nikalti hain, they come out in the form of bubbles. So as soon as you will put the water for heating, to you will observe after few minutes that bubbles start appearing. तो इसका मतलब ये नहीं है वॉटर बॉइल हो गया. नो, वॉटर तो बॉइल अपने टेम्परेचर पर होगा, बट द गैसेज विच वर देयर प्रेजेंट इन द वॉटर स्टार्टेड एस्केपिंग आउट इन द फॉर्म ऑफ बबल्स. इफ यू हैव ट्राइड, आप लोगों ने तो बहुत बार ट्राई किया होगा बबल बर्स्ट करना. जब बबल बर्स्ट करते हो तो उसके अंदर से कुछ निकलता है? नथिंग, बिकॉज बबल इज जस्ट मेड अप ऑफ एयर, मीन्स गैस ओनली. क्लियर? मिक्स एंड दैट कम आउट फ्रॉम द वॉटर. Another example is aerated drinks, means cold drinks, Pepsi, Coke, thumbs up, बहुत पीते होंगे आप लोग, right? So when you will take a cold bottle of any cold drink, Pepsi or thumbs up I will say, and आपको मजा भी बहुत आता होगा bottle shake करने में, when you open it, what happens? शेक करने के बाद जब आप उसको ओपन करोगे, यू विल ऑब्जर्व दैट द कोल्ड ड्रिंक मीन्स द मेनी नंबर ऑफ बबल्स अलोंग विद द कोल्ड ड्रिंक कम आउट विद अ ग्रेट फोर्स. बॉटल में से कोल्ड ड्रिंक बहुत फोर्सिबली बाहर आ रही है. व्हाई सो? बिकॉज जो एरेटेड ड्रिंक्स हैं उसमें गैस मिक्स होती है विद ग्रेट प्रेशर. How they make cold drinks? They mix gas in the cold drinks with a great pressure and they seal the bottle. So as soon as we open the bottle, the gas tends to come out. Tends means try karna, to come out with a great force. And which gas is filled in cold drinks? C capital, O capital, 2 at the bottom. What is this? Carbon dioxide. One atom of carbon, 2 atoms of oxygen, making 1 molecule of carbon dioxide. This gas is present in aerated drinks, means cold drinks, and when we open them, the gas tends to come out, or jab bhi liquid mein se gas bahar nikalti hai to they come out in the form of bubbles. That's why we always say that cold drinks are not good for health. It, why? Because when you are consuming means taking inside the cold drink, it means you are taking inside which gas? Carbon dioxide gas. And we have done this many times, that carbon dioxide gas is not good for our body. Clear? So that is why cold drinks are not good for our body. So next type of solution, last
when we mix one gas into another gas, the very common and the easiest example is present around us. What is that? Air. What is that? Air. Air contain, what is air? You have done from very small class. Mixture of gases. What is air? Mixture of gases. When you mix one gas with another gas. When you mix one gas with another gas. If you will talk about air which is present around us, in this air, nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, many types of gases are present and we cannot feel them separately. We cannot even see them. We cannot see air also. It means gases can be mixed with another gases very easily. One more thing I forgot to tell, that when I was talking about water, that gases are present in water. The explanation is this. We all know that animals like fish, octopus, squids, they all live in water. They all are living things. And living things need which gas to survive? Oxygen. And they do not come out from the water. So from where do they get oxygen? We are getting oxygen from the air present around us. But from where does the animals which are living in water get the oxygen? They are getting the oxygen because oxygen is dissolved in water. So the example of gas in liquid. Clear? So with this we have finished the topic of solution. So now here, what is your work to do? You have to perform activity. You have to show when you will mix solid into solid. You have to show one activity by mixing one type of solid into another type of solid. Then you have to mix one type of solid into another type of liquid. In this you will get two cases. In this you will get two cases. One, जिसमें सॉलिड डिजोल्व हो जाएगा लिक्विड में प्रॉपरली. द सेकेंड इन विच सॉलिड इज नॉट एबल, सॉलिड इज नॉट डिजोल्विंग इन लिक्विड. थर्ड एक्टिविटी यू विल डू व्हेन यू आर मिक्सिंग लिक्विड्स इनटू वन लिक्विड इनटू अनदर लिक्विड. सो इन दिस आल्सो यू विल गेट टू केसेस. व्हाट? वन इन विच द लिक्विड्स आर मिक्सिंग टूगेदर प्रॉपरली, दे विल बी मिसेबल लिक्विड्स. अनदर इन विच द लिक्विड्स आर नॉट मिक्सिंग विद ईच अदर प्रॉपरली, दैट विल बी इमिसेबल लिक्विड्स. So with this we have finished the topic of solution. Clear? So do the activities today only and submit it by tomorrow. Means to, by tomorrow evening you have to submit it. So you are getting a lot of time to do these activities.